We don't have to take us too seriously. We are just cooks, so people think that we're rock stars. They don't understand, especially the young generation. They don't understand that our job is all about hard work and a little bit of talent. But Picasso was always saying, my work is about that. It's about our work every day and with a little bit of talent to express the work.
You talk about the tradition in evolution. Why is it so important, though, to change the traditions of Italian food? Because, as you say, there's three things for an Italian: the football team first, then the Pope, then the traditional Italian food and cooking. Why was it so important to change, reinvent the tradition?
We cannot eat like 50 years ago, like 200 years ago. We have to walk into the kitchen and ask ourselves questions. So if I ask myself, why do I have to boil this beautiful meat into the water to make bollito misto? Bollito misto is the most classic plate every Sunday, every single family in north of Italy, they're eating. But I'm asking myself, looking at this beautiful meat that I am on the counter, the heroic artisan, the heroic farmers, they're giving to me, why do I have to boil the meat into the water? Because I'm losing vitamin, protein, and organoleptic parts. So all the flavor. So with a contemporary mind, thinking about a contemporary technique, I'm cooking sous vide the meat and preserving everything. And I'm not losing the poetry of the past.
It looks, as you display it here in this book, and I'm sure on the plates of your restaurant, which one day I hope to visit, but it looks surreal. It looks like surrealism. It looks like surrealistic art. And the titles too, A Potato Waiting to Become a Truffle.
That's one of the most important plates and the recipe that we create, because for me, it's like it is the chapter of working class heroes. At one point in your life, you have a vision in which you believe in yourself and you say, okay, should I have to try to achieve the 3 stars? For us is an incredible deal, because as an Italian, recognized by the French, is enormous. You know, just to think about that in history, just 8 chefs, Italian chef, then recognized with 3 stars. So you choose to be a chef. You just walk in the kitchen and you see everything with the 2 eyes, with poetry, you know? So if you see a beautiful potato that in the right hands can become better than a truffle. Because, you know, in this plate, what we did, we just cooked the potato under salt and sugar. We empty that. We sprinkle with a little hazelnut. We toast all the shell into the oven. And we refill the potato with a souffle of potato himself and some shaved truffle inside. So it comes out this potato souffle into the potato shell with hazelnut, truffle, vanilla, all these incredible flavors. And a potato, for me, if I have to choose, is I would eat potato the rest of my life, not truffle. So potato is better than truffle. That's the point.
There is so much irony and humor in the book, in your recipes, in your titles. Some of them more obvious than others. The oops, I dropped a lemon tart. I can see how you got to that.
Oops, we dropped a lemon tart. That's a perfect example of poetry. Because create a recipe is an intuition and vision and intuition. You know, that in that moment, when we create that recipe, my pastry chef, a Japanese that is like obsessed about technique and precision, you know, he dropped one of the 2 lemon tart on the counter, on the plate in the wrong way, so upside down. And he was ready to kill himself. But, you know, I said, Taka, don't do it. It's beautiful. It's an amazing, amazing dish. Look at that. It's a photograph. So we rebuilt the second plate as the first mistake, and in a perfect way. So recreate the imperfection through the perfection and meticulous way of thinking. Just, it's all about poetry. That's the secret of our life. If you leave a little space open for poetry, you can jump in and imagine everything.
Do you think an Italian restaurant that serves truly traditional meals, as most of them have eaten them 1,000 times, no art, just food, do you think that kind of restaurant could ever be voted in the top 10 of the best restaurants of the world these days? Or does the best cuisine need something other than good cooking?
No, it would never be voted, you know, because if I want to have a good meal, traditional, really traditional, I would go to my mom's place. She cooked the best meal ever. in traditional way.
With You're traditional not the first techniques. Italian man to tell me that about their mother.
Yeah, I know. That's nostalgia. You understand what I mean? I don't need to go to the Italian restaurant. It's about reinventing. It's about influence. It's about vision. You know, think about what I went through in the beginning when I was trying to create something different, you know, like 5 different aged Parmigiano Reggiano in 5 different texture and temperature. 20 years ago, they were playing jokes with us. They were laughing on us. They want to burn me in the main piazza as a witch, you know, as like 800 years ago. But I thought my idea was really good. And it was just a way to evolve and to see how Parmigiano Reggiano could be used in the kitchen, not just grated on the top of the pasta. That is fantastic, but you know, can express itself much, much more and much deeper. And so I created this recipe. And 20 years later, the 5 different age Parmigiano in 5 different texture and temperature has been rated the plate of the decade for Italian gastronomy. And now is on a website of the Consortium of Parmigiano Reggiano as in the first page. So that what it means? It means that, guys, young chef, if you believe you have a great idea, before or after, the people, they're going to recognize this idea. So keep going, keep, you know, believe in yourself.
Is that part of the motivation for you making this book, which is a work of art, really,
yeah,
and more than a cookbook?
This is a very important point, because the book is not about the recipe. You know, we have 25 pages of recipes, but it's not about the recipes. It's about the ideas. You know, this is the creative process is an incredible cultural expression. So if you start reading all these stories behind every single dish, you see how a plate is creating, because create a recipe is an intellectual action.